हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट वुमेन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। दिस इज लेक्चर वन ऑफ अपर्चर एंटीना सीरीज एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सम थ्योरम्स एंड प्रिंसिपल एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फील्ड इक्विवेलेंस प्रिंसिपल्स एंड समटाइम्स इट The field equivalence principle is also called as a hygiene principle. The following contents will be addressed during this lecture one of aperture antenna series: background history, then classification of aperture antenna, then plane of symmetry theorem, uniqueness theorem, and then after field equivalence principle, and finally how to solve the aperture problem. So we are giving some step procedure through which we can calculate or we can solve the aperture antenna related problem. The following books is considered to develop the content of this lectures. What is background, a class of antenna that has generally analyzed considering the antenna as an opening in a surface is called as aperture antenna. This is the important antenna and through which we can analyze the aperture of the antenna structure. But an aperture contains the opening in a surface, and we can categorize the aperture antenna mainly in four categories: horn antennas, reflector antennas, slot antenna, and lens antenna. We can again subcategorize the horn antenna into the sectoral horn, pyramidal horn, conical horn, corrugated horn, and more categories may also be possible in a horn antennas. We can again categorize the sectoral horn antenna in a E plane and H plane and so more. Reflector antennas can be categorized basically four categories: plane reflector, corner reflector, parabolic and reflector, and spherical reflector. It is mistakenly written parabolic, it's a spherical reflector. And third category is the slot antenna category. So we can categorize slot dipole and slot waveguide. These are the two mainly categories. And the fourth category is the lens antenna, and in which we can categorize the dielectric lens and metal plate lens. These antenna we are going to discuss in subsequent lecture: horn antenna categories, reflector antenna categories, slot antenna categories, and lens antenna categories. Especially horn, reflector and slot antenna categories we are going to discuss in the subsequent lectures. But the lens antenna will be discussed in future. So the radiation characteristics of wire antennas can be determined once the current distribution on the wire is known. This is the basic phenomena that we are using in the case of wire antennas. In the wire antennas, the current distribution on the structure, I mean wire, is known. Then after we can calculate the field radiated by the wire antenna. But in the case of aperture antenna, by using current distribution approach, we can not calculate the field radiated by the aperture antenna, because it depends on the aperture of the antenna structure. So we have to analyze the aperture antenna is the conversion of the original antenna geometry into an equivalent geometry, which can be looked at as radiation through an aperture in a closed surface. So this is important. We are looking at as radiation through an aperture in a closed surface, and the equivalence is established by the use of an important principle, and this principle is known as the field equivalence principle. So we can say, by using field equivalence principle, we can calculate the radiation characteristics of the aperture antenna when we have transform the original antenna geometry into the equivalent geometry, and this equivalent geometry is a closely surface in the form of aperture. Along with this principle, the duality and image principle are also used in the aperture type of analysis. All these can be considered as for the equivalence principles. The field equivalence principle make use of the uniqueness theorem, which state that for the given set of sources and boundary condition in a isotropic medium, the solution to the Maxwell equation is unique. This is the uniqueness theorem, and in detail we will discuss this uniqueness theorem in the subsequent slide. Aperture antennas are most common at microwave frequency and especially used for the aircraft and spacecraft applications. So we can say in the most application of the aperture antennas are the spacecraft and spacecraft applications. First, we need to know the plane of geometry. By using plane of geometry, we can also analyze the aperture antennas. A plane of geometry is another concept that is useful in simplifying a field computation problem. This symmetry can be even or odd in nature. So we can say a plane of symmetry can be even or odd. On the surface of perfect electric conductor, I mean sigma tends to infinity, the tangential electric field ET is zero. And we have analyzed or we have discussed in the electromagnetic theory, when the electric conductor, then tangential component is zero, only the normal component of electric field can exist on its surface. So this is generally termed as a electric wall boundary or E wall. In the absence of physical boundary, in such cases, the tangential electric field have an odd symmetry about the plane, and even symmetry is exhibited by the normal component. So we can say the normal component exhibited the even symmetry, and along the surface component is exhibited the odd symmetry, and this is called as an E wall. The dual of this concept can also be understood in the form of magnetic wall or edge wall. The edge wall bounded, or simply edge wall, is the plane on which the tangential component ST is zero. So we can say in the E wall ET is zero, but in the case of edge wall ST is zero. Again, in the absence of physical boundaries, the normal and tangential components of the magnetic field exhibits even an odd symmetry about the edge wall. So we can understand how the E wall and how the edge wall is performing their characteristics in the form of odd and even symmetries. Then after, we are going to discuss about the uniqueness theorem. The uniqueness theorem can be stated in several different forms, but it is essentially stated that for a given set of or uniquely specified by the sources and boundary conditions in a lossy medium within the region, the solution of Maxwell equation is unique, and this is the uniqueness theorem. Here the boundary condition are the tangential electric field or tangential magnetic fields. These conditions may be applicable in the case of uniqueness theorem. To understand the concept of uniqueness theorem, we have considered a source free volume V in an isotropic homogeneous medium bounded at surface S, and let E1 H1 be the field inside it produced by sources external to the volume. Now again, let E2 and S2 is the another possible set of fields in a volume V. It can be shown that either the tangential component E, electric field, or tangential magnetic field is same on the surface S for the two set of solutions. These fields are identical everywhere in the volume. So we can say inside the volume or surface of the volume, the electric field or magnetic field E or H on the inside and on the surface is same. So we can understand this concept through the uniqueness theorems, and this is known as the uniqueness theorem. The important is here that it is sufficient to equate either the tangential E or the tangential H on S for the solution to be unique. In other words, in source free region, the fields are completely determined by the tangential E or tangential H on the boundary surfaces. So we can say the uniqueness theorem is very important to solve the aperture antennas problem. Then further we are going to discuss about the field equivalence principle, and sometimes it is known as a Huygens principle, and this principle is very important in the case of aperture antennas. And with the use of plane of symmetry, uniqueness theorem, image theory and duality theorems, we are considering to analyze the field radiated by the antennas in the aperture antennas. So to understand the field equivalence principle, we have considered a set of current sources in a homogeneous isotropic medium producing electromagnetic field E and H everywhere. Here you can see, enclose all the sources by a closed surface. As you can see, this is the closed surface S, and we are enclosing this closed surface, separating the entire space into the two parts. This is the internal part and this is the external part, or we can say this is the volume V1 containing the original sources and volume V2 outside this surface being source free. I mean, there is no source exist in the volume V2. Let surface edge is chosen such that it is also source free. I mean, we can assume the surface is also source free, and n cap, or we can say n, be the unit vector normal to the surface, I mean perpendicular to the surface, drawn from volume V1 to the volume V2. As you can see in these figures, the fields and sources radiated by the this field equivalence principle. So according to field equivalence principle, the field in V2, the field in V2 due to the sources in volume V1, I mean the sources exist in a volume V1, these sources may produce the field in the volume V2, can be generated by an equivalent set of virtual sources on the surface. So we can say the virtual sources can be generated on the surface of the volume, and these virtual sources having the current density, electric current density Js and magnetic current density Ms. The current density, electric current density Js can be represented equal to N cross H, and Ms is represented equal to E cross N. In some books it is written minus N cross E, I mean curl of E along the unit vector. So we can represent minus N cross E also. The E and H are the field on the source S produced by the original set of sources in a volume V. So we can say this field E and H is produced by the original sources exist in the volume V, V1. Further, the actual sources produce null fields everywhere in a volume V1. Here Ms represents the magnetic current surface current density and Js is the electric surface current density. So consider a situation where the fields in a volume V2 are same as before, E and H, but we delete all the sources in V1 and assume the field be identical zero everywhere in a volume V1. This is case second. Here we assume that there is no sources exist in a volume V1. In that case, at the boundary surface S, this is the boundary surface S, the fields are discontinuous and hence cannot be suppressed unless we introduce sources on the discontinuous surfaces. I means we cannot produce the field at the surface of this boundary without the actual sources. So we need to introduce the surface current densities on the surface of the boundary. At the boundary surface, the fields are discontinuous. So we introduce surface current sheet on S such that N cross H is equal to JS and E. We have to calculate E cross N equal to MS so that the boundary conditions are satisfied. Through which the tangential E and S satisfy the boundary condition and it is the solution of the Maxwell equation. And from the uniqueness theorem, it is the mainly solution through which we can solve the aperture related problem. So this is the important principle. Thus, the original sources in V1 and the new set of surface current sources produce the same fields E and H in a volume V2. So we can say by using the sources exist in a volume V, we can produce the same electric field E and H outside the volume V1, or we can say in a volume V2 having the same value of E and H field. This is known as the field equivalence principle. The field equivalence principle has the three different forms, as you can see in figure 2. This is figure 2a, and this figure 2a has the surface current density JS and MS over the surface S. The figure 2b represents the surface current density MS alone on the surface, which is a conducting surface, and we can say it's a electrical conductor equivalent. And this is the case figure 2c, where surface current density JS alone on the surface of the S is exist, and it is known as a magnetic conductor surface or magnetic conductor equivalent. So these three cases you can see in a field equivalence principle, and one by one we are going to discuss each case. The first case, in which the surface current density JS and MS radiated in a free space. As you can see in the first case, JS and MS having both current density on the surface of the S, so field radiated by these current densities and can be defined by using Love's equivalence principle. So this is the important principle, Love's equivalence principle, where the JS and MS exist and JS and MS radiating in a free space. So we can use this equivalent provided we can find the tangential E and H fields on the surface S. Most often either or H is available with reasonable accuracy on H. In such cases, for certain choice of the surface S, we can use other two forms. If the tangential component is known on S, so we use second form, and if the tangential H is known on S, the third form is used. All three forms are equivalent as the fields in the region V2 are concerned. So as you can see, this figure 2 example MS, this is only having the JS. So we can define three different forms of field equivalence principle. To prove the second form of the field equivalence principle, as you can see in figure 2b, let us assume that the fields in a V2 are the same as before and the volume V1 is filled with a perfect conducting material. And as you can see, this is a perfect conducting material, and this perfect conducting material makes the E and H field component equal to the zero in a volume V1. The conducting material forces the tangential E becomes zero. Therefore, to keep the fields in V2 the same as before, we introduce a magnetic current density MS. As you can see, so we can introduce the magnetic current density MS E cross N, or in some books they have written N cap minus N cap cross E. just outside the surface as in volume V2. This will restore tangential E to the same value as before, since that E is on the S, so fields in a V2 are unique according to the uniqueness theorem. Similarly, we can prove also in the third form of the field equivalence principle. As you can see in this figure, this is the third form. Here we can generate the JS current density and makes in an electric conductor E and H field equal to 0. So this field inside outside the volume V1 is equivalent as before inside the volume V1 by the actual current sources. So field equivalence principle suggests that the field in V2 can be computed using original sources in V1 or equivalent current sources on V2. Since the S is chosen conveniently some regular surfaces to facilitate easy integration, we use the equivalent sources approach in aperture antenna. This is the important field equivalence principle that can be used to solve the problem of aperture antenna. This approach can be looked upon a two-stage solution to the original antenna problem. First, find the tangential E and H field on the imaginary surface S enclosing the antenna, and then use the equivalent source formulation to compute the far field of the antenna in terms of their equivalent sources. And this is the mainly approach we are using to solve the aperture antenna problems or aperture antenna analysis. The second part, having the vector potential approach to compute the field, and this field we can compute when the current is known. So this is less we are using or almost none we are using in the case of aperture antenna. So this first approach we are using to find the E and H field components using equivalent sources. So this procedure of analysis of field equivalence principle can be summarized in a three-step procedures to solve the problem of aperture-related antennas. So in step one, select an imaginary surface that encloses the actual sources, as we have discussed. And the surface must be judiciously chosen so that the tangential component of the electric or the magnetic fields are known exactly or approximately over its entire span. In many cases, this surface is flat, plane extending to the infinity. So this is the step first. In step 2, over the imaginary surface form equivalent current density J, S and M, S, and will take one of the following forms: J, S and M, S on S, assuming that the E and H fields within the S are not zero. Second case, a J, S or M, S over, assuming that the E and H field within the S are zero, Love's theorem. And MS over S is equal to 0, assuming that the S, the volume, is a perfect electric conductor. And JS over MS is equal to 0, assuming that within the medium is a perfect magnetic conductor, as we have discussed in this section. This is the Love's theorem, this is the magnetic current density, and this is the electric current density having values. So these are the four forms. So the form first, then after we can solve the equivalent problem. The form first and second, the equivalent source formulation can be used to compute the far field, but for form 3 and form, the image theory is used to compute the far field. So we have discussed in this lecture 1 of aperture antenna series some important theorems and related theory through which we can understand the step procedure of field equivalence principle along with different types of analysis of field equivalence principle with magnetic current densities or electric current densities. And also we have discussed the uniqueness theorem to better understand the field equivalence principle. Thank you everyone for watching this lecture. I hope this lecture is beneficial for you.